Hey guys, welcome to your Master That Riff lesson. I'm going to show you how to play HH Boogie by XYZ with Marc Diglio on guitar. Always good to look at a bit of XYZ. So tuning wise, I'm a half step down. So I'm down to E flat here, A flat, D flat, G flat, B flat, and then E flat top. Okay, so HH Boogie is pretty much in key G minor. This little looking at off the cuff kind of intro to this that I've transcribed as well. But the first little part of it is actually the kind of core part of the riff or part of it. Sounds like this. Okay. So this whole tune has got this kind of swung feel to it. So when you're playing this, I'm thinking of imagine your G pentatonic minor here. Then in the third fret. What I'm going to do is slide a little double stop, barring at the second fret on the B and E strings there. And I'm going to slide in and then hit that note again. But the thing about the swung feel of this is swing 16th. You want to have that slide that you land on, there's a little bit longer than that note. Then I'm going to play 5th fret of the G string. And that's kind of cut short, almost like a little rest there. And then I'm going to play my first finger barring the 3rd fret of the G and B strings there. With a little kind of bend on it. Okay. So that's kind of like a little taster of what the full riff is going to be. Now after this, Marc Diglio kind of plays some little noises in the strings. He kind of plays up, hits the string kind of 3 times up here. And then he does a little pick scrape down the B and E strings, and then the last off he kind of scrapes the pick across the G, B and E strings up there. So, you know, you can listen to for the kind of relative pitches, but it's not core to what the song is, but I've transcribed it for a bit of fun anyway. Okay. Then we get into the riff. So this riff has this feel where we're playing just before the bar. So that third fret of the B and E strings, that's on the beat, on the bar, so you can always sliding into it. So before he plays it, there's this little percussive noise. So I guess rhythmically it's kind of coming in on the anda of beat 4. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so you got that little noise, then I'm going to slide, like we did before, and then we have this thing that sounds like this. Okay, so this really cool little pull-off phrase. So after I've done my, I'm going to do pull off 5 to 0 on the D string, pull off 3 to 0 on the G string, then I pull off 5 to 0, 3 to 0 on the D string, and then I play 5 in that D string twice. The second one I dig in a little bit more, so it's a bit more of a pinch harmonic, a bit of vibrato. Now this really helps with the feel of the groove of this. When you're doing these pull-offs, bend the string ever so slightly. So by doing the bend, you spend a little bit longer on the note, therefore you get that kind of swing feel. Okay, so that you can begin to speed up, you know. To practice it, you can start really slow. Yeah, and that's the sort of vibe that you're going for. It's not straight 16th, that swing, yeah. Now after you've done that, I'm going to play 3rd fret of the G and the B strings here with the first finger in the bar. I think first time when I transcribed it, you just hear the G string, but pretty much you're barring those 2 strings again, this double stop. Then you've got the double stop, rest, then a little percussive noise. So I kind of do a downstroke in that, and then an upstroke in that double stop again at the 3rd fret. Rest again, and then I'm going to play double stop, 5th fret of the G and B strings. A good wiggle of a vibrato there. Yeah. So, why don't we do that? Before we get back into the next bar and do the slide, he kind of slides off. actually. You had that. You hear that kind of note sliding off in the G string fifth fret there. So I wondered maybe if he was playing it with the first finger. Yeah. But as long as you've got a feel for getting back into this bit again. So once we've done that, we're back into... Yeah, all the same again. Then we have a... But now, I'm going to play an F power chord now. Before we play that F power chord, so we've done a little double stop at the third fret. And I've done the percussive noise and upstroke. I've now got, okay, you can hear the open E string. So we tease it up and I'm playing the power chord with my thumb. First fret E string, third fingers on the third fret of the A, fourths and third fret of the D. And then I had my middle finger there at the second fret of the G string, but I'm not playing it. I'm kind of thinking like an F chord like that. The reason for that is it keeps my hand in this kind of shape. But if you want, you could play your F power chord kind of usual with the first, third, and fourth fingers, you know. So as long as you can get back, yeah. So that's kind of the first four bars. Next two bars, we start the same again. Then we have this. So now instead of doing like double stop kind of wide vibrato, I play a fifth fret G string pinch harmonic. And I'm playing it just in front of my humbucker here. And it's got this rhythm to it where you pick it up, down, and slide off. So it's almost like two little bends or like really wide vibrato. Then we're back to this again. So that was just the same as the previous two bars where we had the F chord, yeah. Then back into this. Back to our kind of little double stop that we did first off. Again, when you do this though, remember that slide off. And then the last two bars. Yeah, so now he has a little kind of little fill, little lick. So we do the usual. So we get as far as the 5-0-3-0 on the D string. Then I'm going to bend at the G string up a whole step. Release, pull off to 3rd fret, the 5th fret, the D string, and then hammer 3 to 5 on that G string. And it's quite a fast little fill. Yeah. And once I've done that hammer on, I'm going to tap harmonic at the 12th fret of the G string there. So the way I'm doing that is I'm hitting the string right above the metal fret there. To get the 12th fret, and I'm taking my finger away so it rings out. And once again, give it a bit of vibrato on that. And then it kind of slides down the neck from the 10th fret area before getting into kind of the verse, okay? So that, those are the last two bars I'll play again since it is. Okay, and that's it, yeah? Awesome riff. I want to thank Joseph over at the Patreon group for suggesting some more, particularly this tune, but some more XYZ is always great to do. Marc Diglio, it's a great player. That album has just an immense guitar tone, and his playing is something else. And what's really, really cool about this riff is swing feel that he's playing with this. I mean, everyone always cites, like, you know, Van Halen brothers for kind of that swing feel, but Marc Diglio absolutely nails it here. So watch out for that when you're doing this slide. Watch you don't cut do it too quick, because you might think I have to get down here. Sit a little bit longer in that double stop at the third fret than you probably think you need to. So when you slow it down, it should have that kind of sassy groove to it. Yeah. Okay. So, have fun with it, guys. Awesome riff, great tune. If you want access to the animated tab for this, or the guitar profile, or the Helix patch that I created for this to get that kind of Diglio tone, or how I actually went about doing it, then go and check out Master the Guitar on Patreon. All that stuff's available there to patrons. Plus, lots of extra stuff, additional lesson materials for the Master That Solo series, Master That Lick series with jam tracks, etc. as well. You can follow me on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter as well if you use those platforms. And of course, if you're not subscribed, if this is your first time here, please subscribe, hit that notification bell so you're kept up to date with any uploads I do. And if you want to like and comment, please do. That always helps the visibility of the video. So have fun with it, guys, as I said, and I will see you soon.